From a mountaintop in Chile, the Large Synoptic Survey Telescope will look wide, fast and deep, giving us a whole new picture of the universe.
It's actually very gratifying that the NSF has finally moved forward to fund the project. It was apparent to us a decade or more ago that what we needed to do to fully understand the universe was to make a huge survey that went out to the faintest objects over a very wide range of colors and wavelengths, and made a motion picture, effectively, to look at things that move and change in brightness. And for the last decade and a half, I've been working on pushing the envelope of technology so that now we have the capability of doing this. Dark matter is some kind of invisible but massive particle, presumably, that was created in the Big Bang, fills the universe, and clumps under its own self-gravity, creating cosmic structure, and is responsible for the existence, therefore, of stars and planets and us. So the way we image it is by virtue of its effect on the distant galaxies. It causes a mirage. The distant galaxies actually appear in the wrong places in the sky, and this is totally new physics. It is physics beyond the physics that we know today. And that, as a physicist, I find exciting, the fact that there's some new physics. And LSST is the premier instrument for finding out what this stuff is, if it's stuff, what dark energy is. It does a lot of other things. It shows us which comets are coming in our way, which asteroids could collide with the Earth. It will show us the history of the construction of our solar system, but it will also explore the cosmos in a totally new way with 8 separate probes of the dark sector. The main reason I'm personally interested in LSST is because it gives us potentially a lot of insight into new physics. It's something that I've been looking forward to for nearly 2 decades. And it's really great. And everybody on the project is really excited. We're now going transitioning from research and development into construction. What drives me is I enjoy moments in physics where we don't know what's happening. There's a great potential for discovery when you know that there's something wrong with the current model of physics.